Hello everyone. So in today's session, we'll start with the introduction to software engineering. So as all of you students of computer science, you know how to solve the particular problem using the software or using by writing the program. So writing to solve the particular task. So for a simple task, so we have studied or learned, so solving that, writing simple programs. Say for example, now to computerize or automate a larger application or a larger task, so we need to write a set of programs, what we call it as a software. So in student level, so we are going to do so many such projects, but it takes less time. Okay, so within a month or in 2 months, so we can finish that. But actually in the professional's way or in a company, so it should be more organized. So it takes more time to computerize or automate a particular task. So in this branch of software engineering, mainly we deal with so the methodologies for software development. So we'll start with the introduction of software engineering. So as all of us know, so software, we say it is a collection of programs. So for learning purpose, when we do the projects or when we develop a software, so we put actually very less effort and it takes less lines of code, or it will be simple, as we are not going to consider all the factors deciding the quality of the software. But in the professional way, software is by professionals, so it needs much effort. So because the task may be complex, or it should fulfill all the needs of the clients. So it will obviously it contains more lines of code also. So the purpose of student project is just to demo that work, or it mainly for the learning purpose, whereas in professional systems, it is to build the system for the client. So it has to fulfill all the needs of the client. So in professionals development, or when a company develop a software, so actually the software development has some basic problems, or we can say the student project is completely different from the professional projects. So there is a difference, or we can also call it as the domain of problem, the software basic problems in development. So program differs from software in terms of user, documentation, portability, reliability and usability. So IEEE defines, so Institute for Electrical and Electronics Engineering, so it's a standard that defines, according to that, software as a collection of computer programs, procedures, rules and associated documentation and data. So by above definition, software engineering can be described as the development of industrial quality software. So the software developed by an organization, or actually to computerize or automate a particular application, we call it as an industrial quality software. The industrial quality software is completely different from the student project, and there is a key differences between those two. So what we are going to see in this session is, so the problem, actual problems that is faced by industrial strength or industrial quality software. The problems with software development are, so the main one is the industrial strength software. It has to reach the quality of that industrial strength software, and software is expensive, we know that. Another factor, another problem is the late, costly and unreliability. So, and one more is the maintenance and the rework. So these are the problem domain or the basic problems in software development. So by industrial strength software, so it means that, so it has to solve a real problem of any organization. So it should reach the quality issues like portability, robustness, reliability and usability. So product must be thoroughly tested. So whereas in student project, so we give only 5% of effort to test the project. That is just for the demo purpose. Whereas in industrial strength software, 30 to 40% of the effort is put on the testing, because it should be thoroughly tested. So to reach the quality of the software, or to maintain the quality of the software. So the industrial strength software is entirely different from the student project. So another problem with the software development is, so the software development or the softwares, we say it is very expensive. The main reason for this is the software developers, so they automate the other applications. But the development process is not automated and it is completely labor intensive. So that means it is manpower dependent. So as the cost of the hardware is decreasing, cost of the software is increasing. The main reason for this is software development is labor intensive. And the cost of the software is measured in terms of delivered lines of code. The total lines of code delivered to the client or the software consists of. The delivered lines of code is used to measure the software size in the industry. The cost of the development is measured in terms of person months of effort spent in development, productivity in delivered lines of code per person month. Even though it is expensive, it forms major component of an automated system and hardware a very small component. So that the hardware price is decreasing day by day, whereas the software becoming expensive day by day because of it is labor intensive, and that is one of the main problem for software development. Maintaining the cost itself is a main problem. So this graph shows that, so how it increases. So it shows the development of the software, as well as one more thing is the maintenance of the software, so is high. So it is increasing year by year. Okay. Another problem with the software development or the main problem domain is the late, costly and unreliability. So there are many cases where software projects are behind schedule and have heavy cost, or what we say the overrun project. So overrun project or runaway projects are the project which is not under the control of the cost and under the control of the schedule. So in an organization, the survey says that the more than 35% reported having some computer related development project that they categorize as a runaway projects. So the runaway is a project where the budget and the schedule are out of control. The software does not do what it's supposed to do or does what something it is not supposed to do. That means unreliability. The software is not reliable. That means it has to do the task or it has to solve the problem of the client. It has to work according to the needs of the client, but sometimes the software is not working according to that. So because of this quality, software has created many failures in many cases. The industry has reputation of not delivering software within schedule and budget and producing a poor quality software. So we say this time or the schedule and the cost and the unreliability is another major problem in the software development. Most of the times failure in other systems like mechanical and electrical will occur due to the change in physical and electrical properties. In software, failures are due to the bugs, not because of aging. So there is no question of there is no problem of aging in software, but the problem is with the bugs or the errors. So that is introduced during the development itself, but it may occur at any time. In software, error can occur in any stage of usage of software because many a times bug will be there from the beginning but executed at the time of the failure. So this is a problem with the software development. And finally, so we have maintenance and the rework. So once the software is delivered to the client, so that the work is not finished. So it goes into maintenance period. So the maintenance has to be given. So that is also it needs additional effort and additional cost. So it is also one of the problem with the software development. So once the software is delivered and deployed, it enters maintenance phase. Software requires maintenance because some errors remain must be removed when they are discovered. So there are different types of maintenance. We are going to see it next. But whatever it is, whatever the reason, but maintenance should be provided. So it needs extra effort, and that is the challenge for software development. So that maintenance cost or the effort needed is almost 30 to 40% of the total cost invested for the software development. So all these points that gives an idea that software development, the problem with the software development, if you understand the problem of software development, so then it will be easy to implement the methodologies. So we can concentrate on those factors. Okay, so these are the things what we need to know before we start developing the software. So, okay, thank you. Thank you one and all.